start. Yung maugto sa atong natanan. So welcome to our meet and greet kong press conference with our secretary and lead convener for the National Anti-Poverty Commission, Attorney Noel Felongco. So moving forward, may acknowledge our friends from the video who are with us today. Of course, we have Archie Alipalo, first to arrive from Panay News. We have Jude De Los Reyes from Negros Daily Bulletin. Joel Carla Canet from Sunstar. Marshan Muico and team from ABS-CBN. We have Chrissy Samiliano from Visayan Daily Star. Well, of course, Lorenzo Lambati Jr. from PIA, who helped us also invite some of the friends. Max Macanido from Visayan Daily Star. Dolores Epacta Miranda from Negros Weekly. And of course, our friend here, Tootsie Menes from Watchmen Daily. Thank you very much for joining us. Salamat gid sa paghatag niyo sa panahon sa atong na press conference. I would like to also introduce my colleagues from the NAPC Communications team, our lead, Chris Sabal, and Paul of Events, plus the others who are here. At this point, let me share with you a bit about Attorney Noel Felongco para mas makakilala din, natin siya. Attorney Felongco is the son of Mindanao. He was born in Davao City, grew up in Orala, South Cotabato, and finished his Bachelor of Laws in Cotabato City at the Notre University. So Attorney Felongco has served as President of the Partido Democratico Filipino Laban ng Bayan, Pilipi Laban, Central Visayas Chapter. He also served as Counselor for 2 terms of Cotabato City from 1998 to 2004. He also served in the NCIP during the term of former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo from 2008 to 2010 as one of the commissioners. He was appointed by President Duterte as Undersecretary for Solid Waste Management at the Department of Environment and Natural Resources, DENR. Prior to being appointed as the lead convener of the National Anti-Poverty Commission, he served as the chairman CEO of the Presidential Commission for the Urban Poor from February 2018 up to October 2018, where he was able to craft the 5-year development plan of PCUP and the manual of operations of the agency in a short but effective stint as the chairman. Attorney Noel Felongco was appointed by President Duterte as the lead convener of the National Anti-Poverty Commission last November of 2018. So it's my pleasure to give you the convener of the Anti-Poverty Commission, National Anti-Poverty Commission, Secretary Attorney Noel Felongco.
Damong ina salamat sa kaubang Doris. Mayong uto sa tanan. Kabalo man kung mag-ilonggo, pero ang problema ko lang sa ilonggo, kaya kasagunsagon na. May sagol nga Ilonggo, may sagol Cebuano, may Tagalog. Kag sometimes may ara pa nga pag-indanaon. I'm very happy this time na in a just short notice, full force ang media sa Negros Occidental. No, nga ari ni subong para sa atong press conference. So, more or less, muna na ito siguro formal, kaya daw, informal, kaya daw formal kayo itong pakilala sa akong kaina. So, sa NAPC subong, may ina-suggest kami ng mga programa para sa purpose nga i-lower down nato ng poverty incidence sa Pilipinas. From 21.6% to 14% or much lower sa 14%, no? In 2022, at the end of the term of the president, no? And then these programs na siguro na makita mo ninyo na rin, no? May provincial consultative body rollout. Ano ni ang mechanism for us to really reach the goal na ang public incidence sa Pilipinas mapunuran o mapababa. So, ang pinaka-banner program actually is the Sambayanihan Servisyong Sambayanan. Now, this is a program of NAPC which aims to actualize, to really materialize, no? Itong ginatawag natin nga poverty reduction programs of our government. So, ining SSS kung ginatawag namon, amo ni ang isa ka programa sa NAPC as a contribution, no, dito sa marching order of the president to really lower down the poverty incidence and also to fulfill his grand vision for the Philippines, which is embodied in the ambition natin 2040. No? The ambition natin 2040 is an aspiration or a dream of President Rodrigo Duterte that by 2040, ang Pilipinas ma-transform into a middle-class prosperous society. That wala na'y pobre sa Pilipinas, no? May 0% na poverty incidence sa Pilipinas, and nobody will be left behind sa mga economic gains or growth that we have right now, that all Filipinos will be given comfortable life. No? So, this is our contribution. And, ang isa kang mechanism para maglarga itong SSS is the provincial consultative bodies. No? Which is a body to be chaired by the governor and co-chaired by the provincial sectoral leader, no? Or representative na mapili sa mga 14 basic sectors in a province. So, before na mag-convene ang provincial consultative body, may assembly ang mga basic sectors, 14 basic sectors, at ginatawag na muna na provincial sectoral assemblies. Wherein, magpili sila sa ilang sectoral representative who will sit as co-chair for the provincial consultative body. Ang purpose actually sa consultative body is an avenue for the 14 basic sector, no, to have a dialogue with the 14 or more government line agencies including local government units, no, para sa pag tubag or para sa in order for government to positively respond and act on the basic needs of the people. Now, what are these basic needs? We have identified 10 basic needs, no? Na kinahanglan yung sa isa ka tao para mahambal natin nga may aral siya na maginhawa ng buhay o kinabuhi. No? these basic needs are first and foremost, pagkaon, no? Chief, but nutritious and healthy foods, and also affordable, no, na pagkaon, no? Ikaduwa, ang ginatawag naton nga access to clean or potable water, no? Ketatlo, decent shelter. Meaning, kung decent na, dapat may aras ang mga amenities, no? Ano ang mga amenities? Dapat ang balay may aras ang security of tenure ang nag-star, no? Na hindi siya mahadlok na ang gobyerno or any private individual will force him out of his shelter. So, dapat may ara na security of tenure. Tapos, ang paghimo nila is dapat disaster resilience. No? Na hindi dali-dali maguba. Ang mga materials na gihimo dapat hindi substandard. Diba? Tapos, located siya sa out of the danger zones. No? Ang mga na ano, decent. May ara siya na amenities, for example, may eskwelahan, lapit sa iyang employment or sa iyang livelihood, no? May ara na hospital, may ara sa simbahan, may ara sa tanan na kinahanglan niya para mahimo nga comfortable ang iyang kinabuhi. No? So, muna, shelter. Ikat-apat, edukasyon. No? Kay kung tagaan sa oportunidad ng gobyerno, ang tanang mga Pilipinos na maka-eskwela, I think, ining ginatawag nga ito nga poverty incidence, tubong, manaog yun eh. No? Kay we believe that education will really help our people be lifted up from poverty. So, ano na ang education? Either graduate siya sa college or technical or vocational education. No? So, we need the help of the DepEd, CHED, no? And TESDA along that line, para makapacitate ang aton mga Pilipino mahimo nga mga skilled workers or makatabanggit sila to really find a better jobs, no? Or better job, no? So ang ikalima nga basic needs sa tao ang health. Diba? So, as of now, we are happy that the government has passed a law providing all Filipinos PhilHealth coverage. May ginatawag na tayo na universal healthcare law. Na kung sa daan, sa diin ng mga Pilipinos gid, no? Tanan Pilipino, may ara na gid automatic coverage sa PhilHealth. And under the law, ang consultation, basic consultation sa mga doctors will be provided free by the state. So, and we are also happy to note that this week, gihapon, the President signed a law giving expanded maternity no, benefits sa aton ng mga kababaihan. No? 105 days nga maternity benefits. No? So, along that line, naka-respond positively na ang government sa kinahanglan ng health. Diba? Ano pa? Of course, we need ginatawag na ito nga
peace, no? Kapayapaan or kalinaw, no? We need that. Kay kung walay kalinaw, ang tanang mga efforts naton to have more economic growth, wala lang may tabo, di ba? And then, ang pinaka trust yun actually sa NAPC is itong ginatawag natin na people's involvement or participatory governance, wherein our basic sectors will be given the opportunity to participate in the decision-making processes of our government. Diba? So, kung tanang i-enumerate ko ng mga basic needs ma-provide sa atong government, I think it is not impossible for us to really reach our goal and aspiration na by 2022, ang poverty incidence sa Pilipinas will be 14% or much lower than 14%, and the ambition natin 2040 ay ma-achieve gihapon na gihambal ko gani kayo na nga the vision aims that by 2040 wala na sing pobre ang Pilipinas, all Filipinos will be given a comfortable life, the Philippines will be transformed into a prosperous middle class society. So ang to, no? Ang PCB. And then, this is my first time to announce this. Ang tanang na mga naistoryahan, tanang mga naplano, ng mga programa, kag proyekto sa probinsya, kinahanglan ipanaog na sa barangay. No? So, how do we ensure that these programs and projects are properly implemented in the barangay? We have a mechanism, and I just hope that the media will help us along this line to disseminate the information. Dali naman. Yung mechanism is my NAPC volunteers program na himuon. Wherein we will be recruiting volunteers from municipal, city, and barangay levels, no, to help us in giving the right information, giving us feedback, evaluation, and monitoring kung ang mga anti-poverty programs and projects ay talaga bang na-implementa doon sa barangay. We need to begin in the barangay because kung maayos na ang barangay, that will benefit the municipality or city and eventually the whole country. Diba? So, may issue akong SO or special order for that. No? So, kung in a summary, may arata nga sa sambayanan, servisyong sambayanan, na kung sa diin na ini ang convergence ang tanan ng mga national and local government agencies plus the civil society organizations and private sectors, especially business sector, to provide direct services to our people, especially to those who are oppressed, marginalized, poor, and vulnerable sectors. And then, this will be helped by the PCB, no? And eventually, itong ginatawag na itong barangay or NAPC barangay or NAPC volunteers program, no, down to the barangay. So, I'm now open for questions. Daghang salamat. Maayong hapon sa inyong tanan.
Sir,
Okay, so, okay, Teresa from UIRL.
Teresa.
Good afternoon. Sir, we would like to know specific programs, ongoing programs. Meron na kayo dito sa Bacolod, Negros Occidental. Oo, can you name some and mga ilan?
Yes. To name few of these programs which are now being implemented. First, may ginatawag kang community peace landing centers. This program is undertaken jointly by NAPC and DIPAG, Department of Agriculture. So, ang project na tuli is for the construction of buildings, no? And this building will be the center for trading and capacity building of our fisher box. No? The role of NAPC here is to organize the fisher box para maayo ang pag-manage nila sa kining mga centers. Second, may kinatawag na there is sa may Negros Occidental sa mga areas, no, ng mga fisher pox sa mga coastal areas.
Do you have identified LGUs for this fish landing?
Yes, mayara tang listahan. Magkuha na tayo ng listahan.
For 2019, sir, meron ba tayong new?
Ang 2019 new, wala pa, no? Kay may mga projects na pending tapos ongoing. So, ang problema sa 2019, kay ang pondo, di ba, wala pa mga napasa. So, wala pa tayong identify sa mga new sa FLCs.
So for 2018, ilan lang how much is the total cost of the project?
I'm sorry, I cannot really answer, give a definite answer kung pila. No?
How about for 2019, sir, yung nasinulat, no? How about na yung allocate for NAPC?
Sa among NAPC, gamay lang ang among budget actually, no? For 2019, mga 200 plus million lang actually, no? Pero may mga program funds pa na nakalodge sa lahing ng mga ahensya. For example, sa Department of Agrarian Reform, may sa Department of Agriculture, sa DTI, sa PSWD, ano na.
Sir, meron ba tayong figure for poverty insulated sa Negros Occidental?
Sa Negros Occidental, itanong nato na kay I think Negros Occidental belongs to the top 20 kung sabihin na daw taas ang iyang poverty incidence, no? Negros Occidental, ano na ito? Ang poverty incidence sa Negros Occidental is 29.0%. Tapos may poor population nga 867,141.
Poor?
Poor population.
Population.
So 29.01
is? Hindi, 29.0.
Taas
rin siya kaya ang national poverty incidence kay 21.6 lang man. So taas. 29 lang sa Negros Occidental. Sa 2015 eh. 2015 data na Philippine Statistics Authority data.
Ito pa reflected ko na sa data?
Mababalak na nga natuloy sa ano, no? Sa next census, no? Yes, yes.
How do you quantify or measure the poverty?
Ang PSA is sa family income versus expenditure. Nakuha na nila sa ilang survey nga itawag nila family income and expenditure survey. No? Nga may ala sila nga poverty threshold. Ang poverty threshold at the time 2015 ay dapat nasa may ara kang monthly salary, no? In a family of 5 dapat may monthly salary nga 10,000 pesos. No? Pag makubos kapagit, you are considered now poor. Tama na. At tuloy kong ang ano mo sa NAPC na pondo tapos para sa program, di ba? Wala sina. Ang pondo sa NAPC para ni sa capacity building, no? Tapos para ni sa pangsweldo gyapon sa mga empleyado, tapos mga other expenses. I cannot really answer you kung how much ang allocation for Negros Occidental alone. Wala pa. Actually, sa karon ginatapos natin ang roadmap, no? Para sa ginatawag natong human development and poverty reduction. Diba? So, may pondo ang government actually. May arag yun sa pondo. No? Oo. Sige. For 2015, kay PSA man eh, no? Ang survey ginahimo na mga ano, mga 5 years, no ba? So, kung 2019 ta, by next year, mayara na lang na result, di ba? I cannot really answer you kung ano na ang poverty incidence sa buong kay wala man sa lang data get, no? Kaya ang ginagawa natin ng data is ang PSA man, di ba? So, pero ang aton nga gina-target by 2022, ang poverty incidence ma-lower down sa 14%. So, may ara na nga 7.6% nga pagbaba ng poverty incidence, di ba? That's national level. Now, kung sa Negros Occidental, ato ang tanawang yun, no? I cannot really give you the exact number. But of course, since ang poverty incidence sa Negros Occidental, Subong is 29.0 as of 2015 data. So, ano mo ni? For example, pinaka percentage ang share dapat sa Negros Occidental, no? Sa national para makita mo ang pag-iubos gid sa poverty incidence diri sa Negros Occidental. So, amo na.
That's why.
Excuse me.
Of course,
kung ano lang, sinabalikan na itong somebody was asking earlier where the
LLC starts R in Negro, so we have the figure now.
Negro, sorry.
Negros,
you
know, like how many?
Negros. Negros Occidental, particularly.
Okay.
For 2015, may 64 sites ta, tapos 2016, 72 sites, 2018, 42 sites. For Negros, 11 sites.
So, 2018,
11
sites.
11 sites. Ano ang mga particular...
We have
the places. Ano mga lugar?
We have Cadiz.
We have Cadiz, Pontevedra, Timamaylan, San Carlos. Ito rin, sa national, ang pinaka-popular sa Pilipinas, farmers. Kaya may 34.7% siyang poverty incidence. Second, ang aton nga mga fisher folks. Kaya may aral siya nga 34.1%. No? Farmers ang pinaka-pobre. Tapos ang sunod is ang fisher folks, no? So national scale. Of course, it follows na kung ang aton nga mga fisher folks sa national, it follows nga ang sa mga local, pobre kaya po sila, no?
Wala nang lipatan.
Fish landing.
Ihabol namin yung data ng fish landings, kaya just...
Yung mga LGUs na may halang fish landing centers.
Ayan, I think Fab has it.
Ayun, yan.
Sir, ganoon sa mga 11 sites na may mga...
May halang, o.
Sir, may oversight function kayo?
Yes, may halang kami mga oversight functions sa tanang mga... nine agencies in the implementation of the social reform agenda in poverty reduction programs. Kasama dyan. Wala, hindi pa alam ng 2 billion sugar pan.
Did you find it, no?
Well, ako, personally, no? Ako, naniniwala na talagang yung vision na yan, no? Ay makakamit ng Pilipinas. Of course, we want continuity in the present dispensation and sa mga butang na ipanghimo subong, no? Ang aton nga gobyerno subong ginahimo niya gilang iya nga dapat nga himuon para sa mga tao, no? For example, may ara siya nga programa against corruption, di ba? Taga pati man ta nga ang kapubrihon gid sa Pilipinas may ara na connect sa mga corruption, no? So ang gobyerno ni President Rodrigo Duterte seryoso sa pag-curb sa kining tawag naton nga corruption. In fact, sa mga upod ko sa una, no, nga gipang-appoint ni President Duterte mga close niya, iya gigan pang sipa sa pwesto. Di ba? Mayara siya ng programa against illegal drugs. And kabalo man ta,
nga kinahanglan nato awayon ng mga illegal mga drug lords, no? Kay we don't want our country to become a narco state, no? Na maghari-hari nala ang mga drug lords kag mga tao nato, mga youth naton puro na drug addicts, di ba? So we know the effects of illegal drugs in our country. And so far, according to surveys, no, nga gipagawa, majority of the Filipinos are saying that there are fewer or gamay na lang ang mga or nag-decrease ang mga ginatawag nato nga mga drug addicts sa ilang communities, di ba? And then third, may programa ang atong president against criminalities, di ba? Kung sa police statistics naggamay gid man, no? May ara gid man lower down ang mga crimes committed, no? Index and non-index crimes. Tapos ining programa karon ni Presidente Rodrigo Duterte gyapon laban sa kahirapan, no? A war against poverty. Amo ni ang aton nga istoryahan subong. So, if you ask me, nagatuo ba gid ko nga by 2040 ang vision ni President Duterte sa ambisyon natin 2040 nga wala na sang pobre atong ba na ma-achieve, no? Ako, I am very positive on that, no? Kaga we need to, you know, as a nation, as a people, we need to look ang atong future nga may ara na positive nga katuan. Kay kung ako lang, kung puro na lang pa negative, ay di na kaya, wala kita sa himuon. But it is good that the president right now is leading us towards that aspirations and dreams, no? But that by 2040, ang Pilipinas mahimo ng middle class prosperous society nga wala naging sang pobre. Diba? So ako, kaya ni. In fact, sa ginahimo subong sa atong gobyerno nga convergence, no, ng whole of the nation approach, no, ining dream and aspirations, no, makaya gini sa atong nga gobyerno.
Sir, question lang ako, maklaro lang ako, sir. Maklaro lang ako. Sirin mo, makaya mo. Based the facts, ang data mo, 20.16% in 2015, then to 14% by 2022, that is 7.6% at i-reach mo.
Yes.
I-reach mo. Now, 2015, now is 2014. How much and every year? 2019, 4 years from now, apat na ito eh. How many percent na-reduce ini?
Sa subong, I cannot provide you the exact data because what we are telling you here is the target that by 2022.
Wala kayong projection.
Hindi, meron kami projection. Now, may, kay, kung ang 14%, di ba?
7 years na
lang. Oh, ang 14% kasi is 7.6 ang pagano. So, may 6 million to 8 million Filipinos nga ma-live sa poverty. So we have projections. May 5-year development plan kami nga i-present diri gihapon. I do not know kung if that is in the kit, no? Na by 2019, social preparation ta. By 2020, ang target nato is mga 500,000, tapos sa 2021, 1 million, di ba? Tapos sa hanggang 2022.
2022 is
the... So by...
I think it's in the...
Yes.
7 years na mo, tulad kami. How sure we legit na ang public pay?
Excuse me, before we continue, no? Balikan ko lang, si Secretary Felongco just assumed in November of 2018, which means 4 months pa lang siya, no? So we're actually doing
the reason why we are here now is to do the roadmap. So
maybe in the next press conference that we will host here, we will have the figures. We're noting down all of your all of your concerns and questions. No? Then we will have the figures then. Yeah, I understand. Siyempre, we will need figures na mas appropriate for the Negros Occidental audience. We understand that. It's just na currently, ang ginagawa, like ito ngayon, Visayas-wide assessment and planning where we created the roadmap for poverty reduction in the Visayas. So, yun yun.
So, for Negros Occidental, ano ang katukoy ninyo, based on your assessment, ano yung pinaka-project na
Ihimuon pa naman ang assessment and workshop for the provincial. So, mag-assess pa. Mag-imo pa kami. Pero, I like the questions because those will really guide us, no, in our work. No? Kaya, yeah, I really admit that we need data or numbers so that if we talk about targets, no, we are sure that we are really achieving our targets. Kasi kung walang mga numbers, parang maybe we are grouping in the dark, no, and we are just saying things out of the blue, no, so mga ganyan. Wala pa. Okay. Una, our priority here is to really convene the provincial sectoral assembly. No? Ang sectoral assembly will determine which what groups na organized na dari sa probinsya and ano pa ang sector na hindi organized, no? And then we'll see to it that these sectors, the 14 basic sectors, will be able really to participate in the decision making process of our provincial governance, di ba? And then after that, of course, we will identify the leaders of our 14 basic sectors who will sit in the structure of the sectoral assembly, and then one who will be the co-chair of the provincial consultative body. So our PCB will be chaired by the governor and then co-chaired by the provincial, selected provincial sectoral representative.
How much budget do you intend to appropriate for Negros Occidental for 2019?
I'm sorry ma'am, wala pa akong ano yan. Hindi pa po tayo ready.
Just advice na lang, ayok, para lang mapalit so nagtatanan. The latest data, how poor is Negros, or how poor the province is, no?
Kaya ginaano ko, gina-expect ko sa imo ma'am nga ang data naton is sa PSA. Wala pa sing available data. Kaya what is available now is the 2015. So ang 2015 according sa PSA is 29.0. So ang survey is being done every 5 years. So by 2020, we will know the poverty incidence really of Negros Occidental.
But for now, ang guide natin is ang 2015, because that's the only available data that we have. Okay. So si Marshall of ABS-CBN has a question.
Projection niya for Negros alone since 2019 ta from 2015. Projection ta for Negros Occidental for 2022 basing sa mga projects sa subong narin.
So, ako personal, I would like to have that also 14%, no? Kay para pareho ang target sa national kag diri sa provincial or sa local level. Tama na. So, how many ang percentage na mag-lower down? No? So by 2022, no? Makunhuran o malower down sa 14% niya on anatong poverty incidence.
We will know on the 14th.
Secretary, while we believe in the leadership of the incumbent president and also your concern and as the leader of NAPC, we heard that it will be under the provincial government, something like that. Generally kasi, when it is the LGUs, whether it's province or city or municipality, normally when it's the LGU, sometimes the choice of the members of the consultative body, yung kagrupo lang nila. That is the, if I have to say it bluntly now, that is the failure in our local governance. No? O i-assign mo si Juan, yung kumpare natin sa barangay, i-assign mo si ganito. No? So, that is where sometimes the failure of the projects of the president happens. Kasi, it will not reach the purpose. Diba? Well, gusto ninyo, gusto natin na yung we will have to erase out poverty. Kaya yung politicians natin, gusto nila may poverty. Kasi nahirapan na sila manalo. I mean, saying it truly now. Diba? Hindi na pwede bilhin. See? So, that's the concern of NAPC. That's my opinion.
Actually, that is a
what I mean, sorry. Why don't the NAPC involve NGOs who have no personal and vested interest?
That's why, sir, kung na pagkita po kayo na ang presentation, no, na sa PCB, hindi lang din ang governor. It's only chaired by the governor, but co-chaired by the provincial or selected provincial sectoral representative. Tapos, sa structure na, ang 14 representatives represented Gapon. No? Sectoral, tong mga basic sectors, ara sila. And then, upod ang mga line agencies. Tapos, it will be an avenue for dialogue for the 14 basic sectors and the line agencies and the local government units to also plan, no, for poverty reduction activities and for them also to implement. So, it's not correct to say that the PCB will be composed of people chosen only by the governor, no? But in fact, ang mga basic sectors will be autonomous or will be independent in choosing their representatives in the consultative body. So upod ang mga 14 basic sectors. Ano rin mga 14 basic sectors? Una, farmers, naari lang dali, sa listahan, farmers, fisherfolks, women, urban poor, tapos children, youth, indigenous peoples, NGOs, mga cooperatives, tapos victims of calamities and disasters, and workers in the formal sector and informal workers or workers in the informal sector. Those who are vendors, those who are having their sikat-sikat, mga ganyan. So, we have the 14 basic sectors.
Ang media included, Andre. Ang media.
Hindi po, sir. Unfortunately.
You're not small.
Sir, excuse me. Yung sa assessment, sir, hindi ka assessment 11, pero sites.
Sites.
So, sa assessment, yung may mga representatives na nag-attend dito, are they satisfied or nag-change nila life or sa because of the tragedy?
Actually, ang hindi pa sa level ana nga tong impact of the project ang giistorya ni Subong. Ang assessment pa is on the organizational, no? On how NAPC can positively influence or intervene in the affairs of the future Fox. Ang impact isunod na, no? We need to designate people to really make a study on the impact of this FLC in the lives of the fisher folks, especially sa Negros Occidental, no, sa 11 sites.
Sa next press call.
Yeah, sa next press call.
We'll present the results and take assessment.
Jewel, may ara ka pa?
That's the reason why we are having this. That's the reason why we are having this NAPC volunteers program, so that our volunteers will really give us the real information, that they will give us the feedback on how things are being done in the local government units, especially in the barangay. No? So, we need people to volunteer. Of course, if we talk about volunteers, wala ginisweldo, wala ginisang remuneration. No? They are doing things because of love of country and love of their communities. Diba? Oh, labor of love. Ako na. So, may ipagawa akong SO para mabasa kaya po ninyo sa midyakan. Pangayon ko sa tabang ninyo na mag-vlog, ma-disseminate evening NAPC volunteers program. Eh, para dapo sa mag-volunteer, no? I think we have already some partners organizations, no? Nga nagpanawag na sa amon, eh, they really like the idea, no? Nga may ara some people's participation sa assessment, sa monitoring, evaluation, no? Sa mga projects and programs sa barangay level. No, para mabala na ito kung kinahimog yung manuwala.
Dapat na rin sa barangay na start sa may
yes.
Gawa-gawa ng organization, para ipasok.
Wala na budget, puro na.
Okay. Good. Well, ito po si John. So, last
thank you, salamat.
Our press conference, salamat, good kaayo. If you have concerns, no, you can always call, text me.
Okay.
Salamat.